cleansing film of 1996, and now the long-awaited sequel to Independence Day is almost here. Jeff Goldblum has reprised his iconic role, and he's getting some help from Aussie hunk Liam Hemsworth. Angela Bishop sat down with the stars to find out all about Independence Day Resurgence.
We found something out here.
Oh, my God.
Why are they screaming?
They're not screaming.
They're celebrating.
You know, it was almost worth waiting 20 years because it's just so fabulous and there's so much in it. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Did you have fun revisiting this world?
Oh, yeah, totally. It was a trip.
Yeah.
Ask Jeff Goldblum about it. He left off 20 years ago. You know, the first day he was in his part.
Really?
I couldn't believe it how immediately he was, like, back in his character.
That is definitely bigger than the last one.
Without giving too much away, you do get to see a lot of the aliens this time around, and it brought to mind what is going on in Roland's head that he creates all of this. How did he describe it to you at the time?
Towering Inferno.
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah.
You know, these disaster movies in the 70s kind of...
Yeah, big things get knocked over.
Yeah, big things get knocked, a lot of things get destroyed, and then you meet a lot of characters.
Yeah.
You know, he's got a colossal imagination that's very particular, and he has conviction about, yeah, is that going to be like this? And he gets attached to an idea, and he has fun with it.
Yeah.
He's passionate about it for the sheer fun of making it.
Shouldn't we be nervous?
Yeah. I was actually a kid when my mom constantly said, let's put the book down and go on the street. I was always like living in my fantasy world and stuff and read books, and I loved fantasy novels and science fiction novels because I could like really kind of travel to faraway places.
Jeff, your very first role was playing Freak Number One in Charles Bronson in Death Wish.
Freak Number One was the name of my first character. Yeah.
Great memories?
Yeah, I was thrilled. It was the first movie I ever auditioned for. I never went up for a movie before that, and I got it. So I was thrilled about that. I was an eager actor student, you know, as I still am. I was playing this guy far away from myself, streety kind of bad, horrible guy. Yeah, I was kind of excited about it.
Do you remember, Liam, what your very, very first tiny walk-on role? I was in BMX Bandits, so I'm prepared to go on camera
you?
And say that.
You were in BMX Bandits with Nicole Kidman.
Yep.
Yeah.
I was an extra at the waterworks scene, you know, down the water park.
Yeah,
so what was your very first? Oh, great.
What's the name of the movie?
BMX Bandits.
I don't know.
It was one of Nicole Kidman's.
I can't believe you've missed it till now.
I want to see it. I'm going to look for you.
It's a classic.
Really?
It's Nicole Kidman's first film.
Yeah.
Do you remember your very first tiny weenie role, something?
My first speaking role was on McLeod's Daughters. And I was about 17. But before that, the first time I was ever on set was when I did work experience with Chris on Home and Away.
Uh-huh.
Which is basically just went and hung out on the set all week. And then we walked up the beach and parted ways together.
Shirt off?
I think I might have had my shirt off. I think we were walking up the beach with our shirts off.
There we go.
Maybe.
Sign of things to come.
Maybe. Yeah.
We do a lot of great sci-fi work here, a lot of great effects work. We've got a beautiful set of studios just over the way.
And I know.
Pretty amazing.
Ridley is shooting here right
Ridley
now.
Ridley Scott is shooting here. You know, you could do Independence Day 3 right here.
Exactly, yeah, and you have a great like tax incentive too.
There you go. So is it a
And it's a lovely city. I was actually visiting once Bryan Singer when he was doing Superman Returns here.
So, it's a possibility.
He loved it. Yeah. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Can we call it a possibility?
Yeah, sure. Everything is
you're
possible.
You're open to suggestion, and we could get you to bring your freaky aliens down here. It'd be awesome. Roland said ID3 is a possibility, and I've discussed it with him. I've talked him into it. He's going to make it here. Are you all happy with that?
Yeah, I'd be very happy with it.
Really? He said he was going to make it here?
Yeah.
I haven't heard that.
No, well, I discussed it.
Oh, good idea.
So you can finish Thor with... Big Brother Chris.
Yes.
You can move to Australia for a little while.
I'd love to. Come on, let's make it here. He just smiled and gave me a Vegemite sandwich. And he said, I come from a land down
under. Independence Day Resurgence opens across the nation next week.